Talks.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to this session on Amazon DocumentDB Observability. My name is Doug, and I'm an Amazon DocumentDB Specialist Solution Architect. And in this session, I'm going to give a brief introduction to the observability and monitoring features of Amazon DocumentDB. You'll gain a high-level understanding of them so you know when and how to best use them. And I'll give a brief demo of performance insights and data manipulation language, or DML auditing, and wrap up with some resources to help you get started. But first, what is Amazon DocumentDB? Amazon DocumentDB is a scalable, highly durable, fully managed database service for operating mission-critical MongoDB workloads. The architecture allows you to scale your database in, out, up, or down in a matter of minutes, regardless of how much data is in the database. The service provides up to 4 nines of availability with highly durable data storage and 6 copies of your data across 3 availability zones. And AWS manages the underlying hardware, operating system, database software, maintenance, patching, and backups. And we support hundreds of MongoDB APIs, operators, and aggregation stages, and provide wire protocol compatibility with the MongoDB API so your existing applications, drivers, and tools can be used with little or no change. So we remove the undifferentiated heavy lifting of managing the database, and you're responsible for monitoring Amazon DocumentDB by taking advantage of the 5 features listed here: Amazon CloudWatch, the Profiler, Event Subscriptions, Performance Insights, and Auditing. Now, the first is Amazon CloudWatch. You can use CloudWatch to gather and analyze more than 50 metrics published automatically by Amazon DocumentDB. These include instance metrics like CPU utilization, cluster metrics, storage metrics, backup metrics like how much backup storage is being consumed. And you can monitor these from within the Amazon DocumentDB console or within CloudWatch. CloudWatch also lets you set alarms so that you can be notified if any of these metric values breach your specified threshold. The second feature is the Profiler. The Profiler can be used to log the execution details of any slow-running operations, but it is disabled by default, so you must enable it to use it. You can define a threshold, and any operation that takes longer than that to execute will be logged to CloudWatch logs. And then from there, you can use these logs to help improve individual query performance and overall cluster performance. So here's an example of some of the information in one of these log records. Like here you see the timestamp of when the slow operation occurred, the namespace where the operation occurred, the slow command, which in this case is a find where the first name is AFAE, and we see it resulted in a collection scan, which is like a table scan in a relational database. And it took about 1.9 seconds to execute. So from this log, you can determine that creating an index on first name would improve performance of this operation. Now, the third feature is event subscriptions. Amazon DocumentDB automatically generates events grouped into 4 categories: cluster events, instance events, cluster snapshot events, and parameter group events. You could subscribe to these to get notifications via Amazon's simple notification service when they occur. And subscriptions can be on all or specific events generated by all or specific resources in a category. And maybe to put it another way, as an example, you could subscribe to, say, failover events on all of your clusters, or maybe all events on the instances in your production clusters. You've got a lot of flexibility in how you subscribe to those. And even if you don't subscribe to these event notifications, you can view them in the Amazon DocumentDB console. So here you see a cluster failover event, some instance shutdown and restart events, a cluster snapshot or backup creation event, and a parameter group update event where one of the configuration parameters of the service were changed. The fourth feature is performance insights. Performance insights can be used to visualize database load and is disabled by default, so you must enable it to use it. And this allows you to quickly determine what is causing the load in your cluster. You can focus on specific events or look at trends across larger time spans. Performance Insights also publishes 3 CloudWatch metrics that you can use to monitor and alert on database load. Now, here's what database load looks like in Performance Insights, where we chart and display active session information. And by default, this load is sliced or grouped by wait states. And in this example, you see a CPU wait states, meaning the service is executing a query, and IO wait states, meaning the service is reading data or writing data. Now, to determine what is causing this load, you can slice these active sessions or the workload by other dimensions to visualize load caused by specific queries, specific applications, specific hosts, and if you have multiple databases in your cluster, specific databases. The last feature is auditing. Auditing can be used to audit data definition language, or DDL, and data manipulation language, or DML, operations performed in your cluster. It is disabled by default, so you must enable it to use it. And when it is enabled, logs are written to CloudWatch logs, so you can alarm on specific operations that occur in your cluster. Operations are grouped into DDL and DML events. DDL events include things like database operations, like creating a database or enabling change streams, failed and successful authentication attempts, user authorization events, and creating, managing, and dropping roles and users. And DML events include all of the CRUD or create, read, update, and delete operations performed on the data in the cluster. Here's an example of some of the information contained in a DML CloudWatch log record. You see the timestamp of when the operation occurred, the IP address of where the operation originated, the database user that executed the operation, the namespace where the operation was executed, and in this case, we see it was a find operation in the demo.dml namespace. So you can see some of the parameters passed in, but note the log entry doesn't contain the result of the operations. So now that you have an understanding of these features, I'm going to demo the Performance Insights and DML auditing features.
In this first demo, I'm going to show you how to enable and use Performance Insights. So I'm going to go ahead and enable it on an instance in an existing cluster, since Performance Insights can be enabled and disabled on a per instance basis. I'm going to select this live demo instance, modify it, scroll down here to the Performance Insights section and enable that. I'm going to use the default AWS key to encrypt the data that Performance Insights stores. Continue. Now the default is to apply any change in the next maintenance window, but I'm going to apply these changes immediately for the purposes of the demo. And I'll click Modify Instance. Now at this point, Performance Insights is going to be enabled on this instance, which is going to take a few moments. So I'm going to show you Performance Insights on this getting started with DocumentDB cluster that I've already enabled. So over on the left-hand nav, you'll select Performance Insights, and this will open up the Performance Insights console. Select instance that you want. In this case, I know I've got load on this getting started with DocumentDB2 instance. And here, the default is I can see an hour, the past hour of load on this instance. The majority of it is CPU, meaning the service is executing some queries. There's some IO, meaning some data is being read and written. But if I scroll down further, I can further narrow in onto what I'm looking for here. So I see the top weights, which just reflects what's in the chart above. I can see the top queries that were executed across all of the databases and by all of the hosts in this cluster. But we do display these top queries, top hosts, so the hosts that we're connecting to the cluster and executing queries. In this case, they're all from the same host, just different processes. So the port number is different there. The top databases. I've got two databases in the cluster, and I see there's load on the PI and YCSB. And then lastly, the applications. I can see that there are a couple of Python scripts and the YCSB benchmarking utility. But I want to go back to databases, since I see most of the load is on this PI database. And now if I go back up to the top here and look, I see this load is all scoped to this particular PI database. So now I can slice the load on the PI database by different dimensions. I can look at it by query, by host, by database, or by application. But I really want to see which query is causing this load. So for the PI database, I'm going to slice this by query, And now I can just quickly and clearly see that this query represented by blue, this aggregation on the cardata.carmaker is causing the most load. So now at this point, I can go do some further investigation and see, do I have an index? If I do, is the index the correct index to support this? Or if I don't, maybe I need to create an index to support this aggregation. All right, so that's performance insights. Okay, the next demo is going to be about DML auditing. Just like performance insights, it is disabled by default, and it's a two-step process to enable DML auditing. The first is to create a custom parameter group, and we will do that here. I'm going to create a parameter group called live demo, and just a description that I'm enabled DML auditing. So I create that, but this custom parameter group has all of the default values, which means auditing is disabled. So I will need to edit the appropriate parameters, in this case, audit logs. So I want to edit audit logs, and I want to set it to DML read and DML write, which means it's going to export all CRUD operations to the DML audit logs. So I've modified the cluster parameter group, and now I need to apply this to a cluster. So I'm going to go back to my live demo cluster, modify this, and specify this live demo parameter group that has auditing enabled. And I also need to check this box to export audit logs. So it's a bit of a two-step configuration there, the parameter group and the log exports. Go ahead and apply these changes immediately, modify the cluster, and after a few minutes, the cluster will have DML auditing enabled. But I'm going to go now into CloudWatch and show you some of these DML audit logs from a cluster that has auditing enabled. And the audit logs are written to log groups based on the cluster, and the group, the name is /AWS/DocDB/the cluster identifier/audit. So in this case, we're going to look at audit logs for this audit demo cluster here. So let me click on that, and I can see the different log streams. And we're just going to focus on the log streams from today, look at some changes, some CRUD operations from earlier today. And what you can do in log groups and CloudWatch is you can filter these log events. So I'm going to look for inserts into the products collection in my catalog database. All right, I see there are a number of inserts. If I expand this, I can see some more of the details like you saw in the presentation. For example, it was user debouncer on the catalog database, it was an insert into the products collection in the catalog database, and this was the document that was inserted. So you can see all the information about who did it. You see timestamps of when it was done, the host information, and the actual operations. But like I said, we don't record the responses from these in the audit logs. So that's an example of an insert. I can look for find operations. I see that there were two find operations. I can look for updates. You can see that there was an update operation, and deletes. I can see that there was a delete operation, and we'll look at one of those. A lot of the same information, and we can just see the parameter passed in that we wanted to delete the document where SKU is 8976045. And then the last part I want to show here is with alarms. I've created an alarm anytime a document is deleted from that particular collection in the database. An alarm will be raised, and then you can subscribe to those events and have emails or SNS notifications sent to you. All right, so that's DML auditing, and with that, we'll go back to the presentation.
All right, so to get started with Amazon Document DB, and if you've never used it, you're eligible for a 1 month free trial where you get what you see on the screen here, 750 hours of CPU utilization, storage, IOPS, and backup free for 30 days. And if you're already using Document DB and you want to give performance insights and DML auditing a try, like you've seen in the demo, go to our developer guide for more details. So with that, I'd like to thank you for joining the session today.